Man, what's up? It's your boy Plant Based Jeff. I'm here with my guy Torrance, and he chopping up my son. And he's also plant-based too, man. And he just want to share his story, man, because we want to start sharing more stories about black men that are in the lifestyle. I'm not the only one. And I'm in Mississippi. It's a lot of other people, man. So we want to change the narrative. And he got an awesome story, and I just want him to share it and let y'all know about it.
Definitely. Around, 2012, my uncle told me he got diagnosed with prostate cancer. So I didn't know how to feel about that, but he was in a great mood about it. And he was confident that he was handling it. So he had had some treatments and it kind of went away. But later on, years later, it came back and it started to take a toll on his body. So my uncle, mind you, he's like my first real role model. He's an athlete. He's a hard worker. He always exercised. He's always kept great muscle tone. And he was a great person overall. And just watching him fight prostate cancer made me make some critical decisions in my life. I had to decide if prostate cancer hit me, how I was going to deal with it. So I knew then I had to start making different decisions on what I eat. I had to start back working out because I wasn't working out at the time. I was doing a lot of partying, a lot of drinking, some drug abuse, you know, just doing typical party stuff. So I had to make a decision to cut all that out and started eating differently. And I also had a son around 2014. That was another reason I really switched my lifestyle up, because I wanted to live longer and be around for him. So visiting my uncle multiple times at the hospital, watching him battle this disease that even more uncles on my mom's side had to deal with. So two of them died from prostate cancer. So I'm knowing this problem might hit me sometime in the near future. And I just want to be prepared for it, you know. And the best way to be prepared for it is put your body in the right environment to fight off the disease or prevent it. So, you know, I watched my uncle pretty much deteriorate in the hospice. He went from muscle-bound athlete to very small, very frail, can barely lift his head, could barely sit up on his own. You know, I watched him hooked up to tubes and IVs and having fluid and blood drained off his body and his kidneys. So I sat in and experienced that whole visual aspect of it in order to drive me into a different direction than which it did. And 2018, I finally stopped eating meat. That was my last time eating a steak on my birthday in October. So I told myself I wouldn't eat meat anymore. Just dedicate myself to prevent any major health problems that I might run across in the near future. And that's what I've been on since then. Still on the journey. Still, it's 2022 now, so I've been going about 4 years. So that's what I'm on right now. You know, along with the motivation from Plant-Based Jeff and others, I'm living a healthy life, a more healthy life. I feel better. I think better. I think more clear. Making better decisions, and I just plan on keep going, and I'm here to motivate anyone else that needs it.
Cool. And one of the things I remember you told me was about, what did the doctor say? A recommendation they said to you, and that kind of blew me away too. Yeah, that they made to your uncle, and this was towards the end, you said, right?
Yeah, toward the end, in his last days, he told me the doctors told him that he should probably go plant-based. So I said, say what? He was like, yeah, they told me to go plant-based. Just eat vegetables and fruits, no meat. So I'm thinking, why didn't they tell you that from the jump? From the start, maybe you could have been in a better condition.
Right.
He didn't have any answers. So I also decided then, yeah, that is the route for me to go.
Right.
If they're telling you that'll help you now, what if I start now? You know, how far would I get on it? So that motivated me a lot also. And it was also a light bulb popped on as far as what kind of advice doctors have. A lot of them don't have the right advice. A lot of them do, but they won't necessarily give it to you. And it might be too late by the time you get the advice, so.
Right.
It's right. best to do as best you can, eat as clean as you can, as early as you can,
right,
to prevent all the bad diseases.
And we both from the same town, man. We're in Jackson, Mississippi right now, man. So something that a lot of people don't think, like plant-based people not in Mississippi, or I'm the only one from Mississippi, but like he been putting me on to different spots, different vegan spots down here in Jackson, different herb shops. Man, like it really blew my mind. So next time I come down here, I'm gonna start visiting these places. He go connect me to some other people. So we go get their stories and just make a movement out of this. Cause man, Mississippi wants to be healthy too. We may be known for being, you know, the most obese or the sickest, unhealthiest state, but we changing that narrative.
Definitely.
You know, one person at a time, in the barbershops. I wish we had more people in here, man, where we could be just spreading that same news to right. them. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
So man, I'm glad you shared that story, man. I'ma definitely share it with other people on all my socials, on my YouTube, because somebody listening to this trying to figure it out, like, man, should I do this? And tell them how old you are.
I'm 40.
Man.
You
wouldn't even know it. My guy looking 25 over here, man. 25. He working out, keeping himself up. Damn. Telling you, man, that plant-based lifestyle will not only treat you right, have you feeling good, have you looking good.
Right.
I'm telling you, man, it will reverse some stuff, man. It will reverse your aging. I'm telling you. So I'm trying to put my son on right here. You going plant-based too, right? You going plant-based? Oh, now he want to go plant-based when I asked him. Now he done heard another man, but that's what we need, man, when we here in our community.
Right.
Because the young kids are listening. So I made sure he heard the story. You know, he done heard the story twice now. He know how serious this is. He knows my story, but now it just gives him something to look forward to and know, like, hey, man, it's other guys beside my dad that are, you know, black men that are taking care of themselves and doing plant-based. So
right.
I'm really appreciative of you, for one, sharing it with all the people, but also for him to witness it at the same time.
For sure.
Because that could be an influence. His words may be like, oh, okay. Because a lot of time with kids, they got to hear one or two other places. Right. Yeah. And then, like, because he just hear me talk about it, may just think I'm just, you know, one man against the machine.
Yeah.
But no, that's not the case, man. It's other people, black men, black women.
And entire community.
Man, entire communities. Yeah. Right here in Mississippi, right here in Jackson, man. And we go get their stories, man. And I appreciate your brother so much for that, man. Really do, man. And appreciate the fresh cut. He got me in the game, y'all. I'm going to flip it around so y'all can see. The man ain't even, man, he healing heads and he healing, you know, helping people heal healthy-wise, man. So I appreciate that, man. We go definitely shoot this to the world.
Okay.
All right.